So let's see whether the Hawks can use the breeze a bit better.
It's bad enough you get them at home at
night. I know.
Surely you wouldn't make this many mistakes at work.
Start of the second term, 2-2 playing 1-1. And first ruck, Hybens tries to get it down. He's on hands and knees. He tries to give it away to Muir in the end. Fresh air shots of galore in there. Burke's in there as well. Now Kelly breaks through with the handball. Goes towards half forward. Drew gets back there as well. For Inverleigh, over the top of it. Got the handball free. Holzbein, little toe poke off the ground. Might be okay, but coming the other way, Hutchinson. He goes towards the middle of the ground. Meehan presents again. Got a hand to it. Needs to try. Oh, he does nicely. Traps it and gets the handball away. Muir, if it sits for him, he's back away. He can. He's at half forward. Goes short with a kick. Mays takes the mark. So Nathan May, still 65 out. He tries to chip the ball to Rusty. Gerard, Urquhart right next to him. He's on his left. He works around. Goes close to the boundary line. Brings it back towards the goal square. Carson runs back with a fly to the footy. Barton gets back there as well. And he takes the mark for Bell Post Hill in the last line of defence. So a minute played. He goes short to Popovsky. Takes the mark inside defensive 50. And Nick Popovsky. Oh, sets it up for Lime. Occasions comes at him. Dangerous one-on-one coming in. Grundle as well. Rides the tackle nicely. Gets it away to Cations. Breaks free. Handballs it. Groz comes in. Oh, and he misses.
He had a bit more time too.
He did, and threw for one behind to Mick Grozdanowski. So they got a 1-2-8 in Bali. They trail Bell Post still 2-2-14. Common Affair Hotel second quarter scoreboard. Minute and a half played.
Did you tell you what? He just rushed that kick a little bit, thinking that the...
Because they did the hard work for him, didn't they?
Yeah, they did. I thought he thought the Bell Post Hill player was closer than that. He could have just taken another step, steadied and delivered. G'day, Trout. Crow, Worm, whatever they call you down here.
Ferret.
So Lyman now doing the kicking in duties. He does so often. He might have been in the Lynx job from last week, but he's in able to hold on to that. He goes out long, outside 50. Love it in front. Hybens gets hands of ball, picked up. Meehan handballs back over the top to Drew. Runs inside 50, kicks long towards goal. And Jordy Drew has got his first goal of the afternoon. And the second for Inverleigh. And scores are locked away. 2-2 apiece. Bell Post still in Inverleigh. And we have just gone 2 minutes, second quarter. Commonwealth Hotel, second quarter scoreboard.
Look, they've come out a different side today, Inverleigh. And I actually tipped this before the game. And I hope they can continue in this vein because they're actually playing better football than Bell Post Hill, probably for most of the game so far. What they've got to do now is make sure that they kick goals when they've got their opportunities. If they can do that, as I said, a quarter time, they can set up a win in this quarter.
So Drew kicks his first. And back to the middle. Hybens and Lovett. Umpire with the ball in hand. Puts it in the air. And either ruckman get an effective tap. Hybens over the top of it. Lovett puts the tackle on him. The two big fellas will set up and do it all again. In the middle of the ground. So the umpire comes in. Sets up play again. Lovett gets it down. Rowed by Hutchinson. Kick towards half forward. Urquhart tried to trap it. He does the third time. He's over the top of it. As he slung off the ball, the umpire said play on. Ball still in dispute in the middle. Ball comes out. Muir puts the tackle on. Hawks trying to get the kick away from in the middle. The ball was nearly out to me, and it is. Goes past him, half forward now. Carson breaks free, handballs it away quickly. Grozdanowski off a step, goes inboard towards Mays, who can run onto if it sits. It doesn't, though, and he falls over.
Barton he gets a free
swings
kick,
it off the
surely.
Football. The umpire says play on. Over the top of it, Addy comes across. The kick comes out for Bell Post Hill. That might be okay. They've got a 3-on-1. Urquhart, handball, back inboard. Meehan puts the some good pressure on, but Zulix gets the kick away. And now they're through centre wing. They go with a chain of handballs. Barlow gives it back to Will Kelly. Off a step towards half forward. Might sit over the back okay. Hawks under pressure in defence now. Handball comes back to Burke at centre half forward. He just chips the ball up. And Page takes the mark and will shoot for goal from 40 metres out directly in front.
Well, that's as good a football as we've seen all day. That was brilliant football. And when I say that Inverleigh can set up a win, all of a sudden, Bell Post Hill give us this, don't they? They just show us how good they are because that was just beautiful football, running the ball into the wind.
So Joel Page comes in, northern end of the ground. Well, Right foot kick with the breeze. Doesn't come back far enough. Sits out and is through for one behind. So
bit of a shame.
They got a 2-3-15 bell post tilt. Take the lead though. Inverleigh 2-2-14. Common Affine Hotel. Second quarter scoreboard. 5 minutes played.
Well, this is going to be a close game this bit. This is going to be nil all day by the looks of things over there. We'll have a penalty shootout, will we?
Hutchison short, dangerous. Ball's been turned over at ground level, picked up. Ettridge gets the handball back to Page. Page again from outside 50, comes back inside. Burke comes up and takes the mark. And that's Reece Burke we're talking about. So he'll go back now and have a chance to kick for goal. As we're joined by Alex. Alex, you got the car out of the bog, mate, did you?
Oh, don't tell me this idiot's turned up.
But you know what? It's just luck. Mitch last week, me, I hope it's Gravy next week. So,
so Reece Burke now to come in, 35 metres out from goal, kicks it goal. It's a bit better than the last one, but it's just
still a point.
Gone offline and through for a minor score. So bell post hill, a couple of opportunities, 2-4 now. They lead Inverleigh on 2-2, and we've gone 6 minutes. Second corner, Common Affine Hotel, second quarter scoreboard.
Hello, Alex, how are you?
Yeah, rushed, I think, would be the appropriate word.
Rushed.
But,
don't they have mud in Lithuania?
Oh, I didn't have basketballers if you saw the weekend's result.
Well, Australia didn't have any today.
Yeah, that was shocking.
So Hutchison from full back doing the kicking, goes to the outer side, looks for Walsh, Barlow with the sit at the back. Walsh on hands and knees, tries to get the footy out. Bellpost still had the numbers. Walsh, can he keep it in? The umpire says play on. Ball somehow. Muir just roves it out of the and rips it out of the pack. Meehan got the handball away. They're on centre wing now. Inverleigh. They go around the boundary. Addy in front
too
of Carson.
Good for him that time.
And Addy took the mark at half back for the Panthers.
God, he's a good player, this bloke.
So Addy high and long with the kick to the outer side. Off hands and out of bounds for a throw in. So we played 7 minutes. Second term. Qualifying final point. The 2 points of difference. 2-4 playing 2-2. Boundary throwing just forward of centre wing for Bell Post Hill. Oh, over the ruck when the contest.
That?
Falls in the arms of Hybens in the end. He gives the handball away. Logue wheels around on the left. Goes to half forward. At the back, Popovsky. Can't take the mark. Whoa, the umpire's paid the mark.
It come off one player onto the other, you stupid glass.
Look how close these two blokes are.
So Inverleigh go inboard. Carson's got the sit at the back, and he takes the mark.
That's a shocking decision.
Not much Cam Addy could do there. And Paul Carson will shoot for goal from 20 metres out directly in front.
The Bell Post Hill bloke takes the first grab. The Inverleigh bloke takes the second grab, and they pay the mark. Have they changed the rules here, have they? That's ridiculous.
So, Paul Carson, who's kicked 80 this season, coming in for his first of the afternoon, and to give Inverleigh the lead again. He made hard work of it, but he just squeezed it in and threw for a goal. So, his first, and the third for Inverleigh. They go to 3-2-20. They lead Bell Post Hill 2-4-16, and that's on the Common Affine Hotel. Second quarter scoreboard, 8 minutes played.
Well, that's where I've seen McDowell have Carson up the ground a little bit. That's where he's got to be, down there. I know he drifts back and he's got to be down there one-on-one with Addy. I know he got the advantageous kick into him then. But oh, I can't believe they paid that decision. My only question to you, Smitty, is where's Nachos and his mates from last week?
They're in the GFL, the Nachos.
Yeah, well, they were terrific last week. I would love to have had those blokes back. That's the best display of umpire I've seen. But that was a terrible decision.
And we're back with the umpire, middle of the ground. Both Ruckman have been at it all day, and they'll continue to do so. Muir going, gets the clearance, got the handball away, interception. Fantella has done nicely, picked up there by Hamer. Handball goes back to Cations, and he now swivels and goes towards the half forward line. Popovsky leads in the race.
That's
Hamer.
Great courage.
Oh, he's knocked his own teammate out.
A bit of self-flyer there, and friendly fire, I should say. Right. Sulix takes him on, and then couldn't get the handball away. Good tackle, Robbie Logue, and he will win the free kick for Inverleigh. So Logue now
50.
With the ball just inside the forward 50. Sorry, inside the defensive centre square. He goes out towards Carson once again. He's up and ball comes down. Addy able to pick the ball up. Goes in the left boot. Dribbles it back towards the centre wing. Coming the other way is Cation. Picked up by Gerard. Handball goes back towards Hybens. He looks up and goes long into the forward line. Carson's best out of the back. Hutchison.
Now that's a free kick against Carson, surely.
That's a nice grab there, Blake Hutchison. And he will go back and shoot for goal. Five metres out from goal. And not a great angle here to work with. will work against him here. But he's going to, on his favourite left foot side, will come in. And he's made a mess of that. So Blake Hutchison, a minor score, 3-3 now to Invalee, and 2-4 to Belpo still, 10 minutes gone. Second quarter, Common Affine Hotel, second quarter scoreboard.
What did Carso do then? He just sort of flew in the air with his leg back like a donkey kick and got in everybody's way, and it fell into Hutchinson's arms. Oh, you can't do that. That's a block or something, isn't it? Interference, whatever you want.
He had eyes on the ball. I don't think it saved him.
No, he didn't.
Limer plays on from full back, goes to the outer side, outside 50. Pack develops over the back of it. Oh, great pickup by Perrott. It gets back around on the left, but he's wrapped up, and the umpire says, punst him. Thank you. Will Kelly will take the free kick in between half-back and centre wing on the outer side.
Hello, the scoreboard's working.
Yeah, perfect.
Is it right?
I don't know. Don't think so. So anyway, ball goes towards centre wing. Oh, coming up. Good mark, too.
That was a reserve score.
Yeah, it was. So now back towards Kelly. Goes towards centre forward and chopped off. Burke takes the mark for Invalee. Only have to listen to one, people. That's us. Listen to us for the score. Don't worry about anybody else around the ground. Ball in dispute. Will Kelly again. Handball. Oh, punts the throw. So Invalee will take the free kick. Halfback flank out of side. And they get the ball moving. Through set of hands. Kick over the top. It's okay. Muir takes the mark on centre wing. Back inboard.
Now bring it this side.
Violet. Gets around, looking for somebody to run off half-back. It was a terrible handball. Hamer, Barlow, tackle on, pressure in the middle.
Well done.
Popovsky got the handball away to Barlow. They got the numbers bell post till, but then they give it up. Ooh, hey, good right. Tackle. No, umpire says play on. Ball still in dispute in the middle. And somehow comes out towards Grundle. He can't take it with him. Now it comes back. Muir with it, just a quick kick towards centre-half forward. Over the top, Limer, Hutchinson's there, handballed it out, Carson to run onto it, Addy, his handball over the top, Mays, chopped off though by Lentini, his handball was nowhere though, Gerard, he can't take it with him, back towards Lentini at half back, takes a bounce, settles the play, goes towards centre wing, oh, good mark, in the middle was a free kick anyway, I think, and de Blasio it was, I think, who took the mark, he goes short and out wide, Muir takes the mark. Plays on quickly, chips the ball back in. Gerard, he takes it. So Gerard in between wing and half forward on the outer side. Called to play on. Chips the ball. Hutchinson, Limer though, chops it off for bell post till Panthers resist another one. They're 2-4-16 in Invalee, 3-3-21. 13 minutes played, second term.
That was a rubbish kick, an absolute rubbish kick, that one. Kick it long.
So Limer does go long, but he goes back to the far side of the ground. Contest out the far side. Marker's not taken. Ground level picked up by Gwozdanowski. Had it and lost it. Kicked off the ground by Costello. Picked up by Burke. Goes inside 50. Arcioni in front. Page over the back. Had the sit. Couldn't take the mark. Went and collected it again. Got the handball away. Kelly. He couldn't take clean possession. Picked up by Costello. Got the handball out. Only as far as Cajun's. Got the handball over the top to Hamer. And he goes across the face of goal. Dangerous kick. Leading in the race for the ball. Holds fine. Has to take on Burke. Burke had him. And then he let him go. Did nicely. Oh, was that out of bounds in the full? No, the ball had gone over the boundary line before it hit Holzwein's foot. And we'll have a throw in the forward line for bell post Hill.
If you tap the ball out and the bloke grabs you and pulls you to the ground, that's the biggest hold in the man I've ever seen in my life. Ever.
So throw in by the umpire.
You grab the ball and go like that and they give you a hold in the ball. Yeah. It just doesn't add up.
Picked up Turner, goes into the forward line. Ettridge leads in the race for the ball. Ground level, ball, what's it going to do? He taps it back behind him, has support there. It's done well, and that was Flacavento running the ball towards the boundary line. Just needs to pick it up. He's done so now. Needs to get it out, got it out, and the ball goes over the boundary line and will be a throw-in. Such a big ground, these umpires. They've got two blokes sitting inside each other's pocket and the other bloke about 150 metres away.
It's the way they do it now. I can't see a reason for it, but maybe they've got one. I don't know.
So the ball thrown back in, forward pocket, handball comes over the top. Gerard there, I think it is, couldn't take clean possession of the ball. So now the ball in dispute in the forward line. Players over the contest, it comes out. It's running towards the boundary line and will go over. So a throw in about 20 metres around from the behind post. Bell post Hill deep into attack.
I think we have a record of vicinity listeners. I haven't heard so many car radios on that simply because of the scoreboard. So what is it for real now?
So the ball is kicked around the corner, and I think that's a goal. I'm not too sure who kicked it. body, Willie Urquhart, was it? So I'll give it to Willie Urquhart because I think he's... I've got no idea. Did you see the kick?
No, I didn't. I was looking at the score.
Well, it's a goal. We're going to give it to Willie. I'm not too sure whether he got the goal, but it's 3-4 to Bell Post Hill and 3-3 to Inverleigh. So Bell Post Hill with the lead, and we have gone 15 minutes second quarter. Coming to Fien Hotel, second quarter scoreboard.
Well, I wasn't sure what happened then, and I was listening to some idiot tell us about car radios.
Well, that's what happens when the scoreboard doesn't work. Exactly. 4-4 to 2-5.
When did you get here? Get back in the bog, you idiot.
Back in the middle. So, middle stage of the second term. Point the difference. Back in the middle, Lovett and Hybens. Lovett gets it down. Kelly wrapped up straight away. Hutchinson and Muir. Muir runs away and just gets the kick under pressure, but Urquhart.
That's great pressure, Holsford. Fantastic.
Takes the mark. Centre half back, Will Urquhart. Drives the ball into the middle. Pop takes the mark. Popovsky goes to the outer side. Sets it up. Lets Lima run onto it. Goes with a kick now towards half forward. Panthers starting to control the footy a little bit. Now they go with the kick out wide. And it might be too wide, in fact. And out of bounds for a throw in. Right half forward flank on the outer side for the Panthers, attacking the northern end of the second term. So a throw in. Lovett's down there. Gets it down with the left fist to the front of the pack. File it around the corner, and they see it over the boundary line again. A little bit closer to the Bell Post Hill goal now, about 25 metres around. And boundary throw in. So Lovett up against Hybens. Neither get an effective tap. Hybens tries to do the roving work as well. Runs past the footy as they're high. The umpire says play on. Ball still in dispute. Can't break free from the contest, and he'll come in and ball it up. Still 25, 30 metres out from goal. Big pack around the ball too. Lovett goes up early. Hybens takes down the ruck. Kick was partly smothered. Close to the boundary line. And this is a shit game of footy. Can I tell you right now, 55 metres around from goal. And somebody do something, for God's sake. Somebody in the box do something.
Well, at least I won't get in
Grubby,
trouble.
Do something.
Do you want me to go out and get a kick from
him? Go out and get a kick. Do something as boring as batshit. For God's sake.
Ball thrown back in the forward line. Tapped out. Lovett goes into the forward line. Picked up. Violet. And he's tackled. Brought to ground. How will the umpire see it? The umpire says he didn't have an opportunity to get rid of the ball. I thought that was my phone. Then I was going to say, don't send me any more messages. So in the forward line. So Bell Post Hill, they've kept it down there for the last 4 or 5 minutes. They need to make another scoring opportunity here. Trying to get the ball out. Ends up to Costello. Goes towards Barlow. Picked up there. And the kick was... he tried to kick the ball. Missed it. So the umpires pinged him.
It's like under 14 footy. They're all just following it like little ants.
Yeah, they are. I've watched enough footy this
morning. Mark there by Dan Groz. So Dan Groz has got the ball just outside 50. Now he's been called back. 50-metre penalty.
Well, that's why the umpires are paying stupid, shocking decisions to open the play up.
Yeah, that's right. Shouldn't have to.
No, they shouldn't. So
Dan Groz now with the football. He's got his brother running forward and hard. He's going to go in that direction. He goes short. Little chip forward at the back. Popovsky. It's a holding decision, and it goes to Popper. And there's a wrestle on here. Adam Muir just saying hello to his
counterpart.
Oh, nothing
counterpart
in that.
There. And that wasn't to say same number, but it's not. But it's Anthony Pisano. So Pop's got the free kick. Half back line. Bell Post Hill. Not too much movement. Towards centre wing, he's got Justin Tarr just snuck onto the ground. That's the direction he goes in. He's up. Mark's not
Justin
taken.
Tarr sneak on the
there.
Ground.
Goes. So he did. He just snuck around the boundary line. He did a Stevie J. Ball is up in the hands of Groz. Can't pick the ball up. It's tapped out. Picked up by Barton. Had it. Lost it. Went into his legs and under his legs. Picked up by Urquhart. Out the back to Burke. And Burke now goes into the half forward line. Coming up to meet the ball. Ettridge. Oh, I thought he had enough of it. But put it down in the last minute. At ground level, Welves there. Also Inverleigh with numbers. Ball out the back it comes. In up in the hands of Limer. Did get boots of ball to the half forward line. Going back and picking the ball up is Drew. Steaming through. Looked up and kicked the ball back into the middle of the ground. Meehan can't take the mark. Followed up nicely. Picked it up. Oh, second handball was only just picked up there by Lentini. Goes back to Popovsky. Stopped and propped. Looked sideways, put himself under pressure. Barton has to go. Muir did nicely. Picked the ball up, a short kick. It's all it needed. Out to his brother and Adam.
Can
he play
keep
on?
Going.
He's going to stop. He's going to go back and shoot towards goal.
Not only did he put himself under pressure, Smith, he's put his teammates under pressure with that little kick.
So Adam Muir now with an opportunity. I think it might be nearly his first touch of the day, but it could be an important one for Inverleigh. So he's a pretty good kick for goal, normally, Adam Muir.
Oh, well, there we go. Put the moz on.
This will go straight out of that shed over there.
Straight to the netball court.
This will go straight through the middle. So Adam Muir. This is what he's in the side for. Chips towards goal. It's done very, very nicely.
That's right in the middle.
And it's the fourth goal for Inverleigh. They're 4-3. They lead Belpo still on 3-4. And we have gone 20 minutes into the second quarter. Commonwealth Hotel, second quarter scoreboard.
Again, they did a little bit what Belpo still. They haven't had the ball up here much. And when they did get it up, they scored a goal. So that's what you've got to keep trying to do. But as for Justin Tarr sneaking onto the ground, it'd be like an elephant hiding behind a bamboo tree.
Justin Tarr snakes on the ground. A veteran would never said that before. Snakes on the ground. Geelong over to 7-12-54, lead Queenscliff 3-2-20 in the second semi in the Ballarat. It's all over there.
No one can beat them, can they?
Yeah, wouldn't have thought so.
Got the goal kickers. How's Daisy's kid going? He kicked any?
Don't know. Hasn't got him yet. What do you want? I'll give you the score. Gee whiz.
He's a good kid. This old man was a good player too.
Who are we talking about?
Mitch Day.
His old man played VFA with Werribee and Sunshine.
Night End. That was his first name. Mays, through the middle. Oh, Popovsky by himself. Takes the mark at centre-half back for the Panthers. Uncontested. Hopefully this kick's a bit better than the last one. Yeah. Kick straight to Muir. Goes to the outer side. Oh, it's a good kick, Barton. And makes it good too. Takes the mark. Handballs it away. Barlow. Ford goes with a kick now towards Page on a lead. Good kick. Can they play footy like that more often?
I don't know, but you've got to ask the question. Walsh wore him like a glove last week and today, and he was not within 40 metres of him then. Where was he?
So Page now. Kick for goal. He's going to be kicking close to the boundary line. Tough kick this, straight back into the breeze. 45 out. Right half forward flank.
This would take about as good a kick as he's ever kicked in his career. This is more than a tough kick.
So he comes in. Joel Page, right foot. Holds it up in the breeze and has missed everything, has he? Just squeezed it in from behind. So they go to 3-5-23, Bell Post Hill. Archery and Inverleigh, 4-3-27. Commonwealth Hotel, second quarter scoreboard, 22 minutes played.
Short kick out to the pocket, finds Logie, plays on quickly, goes outside 50, kick, went to Armstrong, it was a good kick. Back inside, the running player is Drew, land forward, kick one going forward, wasn't too good. Addy just thumps the ball back to where it came from. Armstrong, Henley had it cleanly, taps it back for himself, but it ends up in the hands of Barlow, missed well. Out the back now, Logue has it, over the top of the ball, it's bouncing around a bit, a little bobbling around a bit. Ball ends up in the hands of Hamer, looks sideways and finds out a Muir. So Muir now on the defensive side of centre wing. Has the ball. This is Adam. And he's now looking for options further afield. Short player is Grundle. And he ignores him. He goes short back to Hamer. Hamer goes to Grundle. Kick wasn't good. Grundle picks the ball up. Got the handball away to Grozdanovsky. Mick. And now can stand and look and go long into the forward line.
Down the ground. Tari's hit him late.
And
Tari.
Now, where does the kick get taken from?
After, isn't it?
Well, it's got to be down the ground, but it went through for a point or out of bounds.
No, it's going to Carson.
Hit the behind post. So Carson down the field, free kick. And it will be his second goal if he kicks accurate from this position.
I've got to check that rule.
If that had scored, I think it had to, would have had to have come
No, back. Even if it goes out of bounds.
Ooh. Ooh.
Oh, it's come
Just
around.
Got in.
Only just come in.
And
it, well, I think maybe. I don't know. He kicked it that
what
high.
Is goal? Umpire, what is it, a goal past decision. The goals?
5-3 in the lead. That's 33-3-5 to the Bell Post still side. And we have gone 24 minutes, second quarter. Commonwealth Hotel, second quarter scoreboard.
Well, you got a stats book. You got a rule book?
Nah, don't say. No, I'm not an umpire.
I'd like to check that. If it goes out of play in any way, the ball's got to come back to the bloke.
I'm sure at half time there'll be an umpire in there you can ask, Grub.
Well, I will.
There'll be about 300 of them in there.
Well, I will. But I've got a funny feeling none of them
don't
will
forget,
know the answer.
Don't forget we're rating Grubby's half time entertainments too today. You need to give us a score out of 10 for the half time.
Well, I tell you what, North Geelong got the canine, so I'm already contemplating it now.
Back in the middle. Tarr having a run in the rack. Hybens gets it down. Through the middle. Mick Groz again. Right foot kick towards centre-half forward. Muir, that's a hold. Umpire says yes, please. And Lima will take the free kick at half-back. So Shane Lama. Zulik short. Goes in that direction. And also Burke's there as well. Offhands Mueller. Burke back into his arms. Pisano off a step. Left foot kick around the corner. Oh, Holzfein goes up. Party trick wise. Doesn't get anything. Through the middle, Dan Groz goes with a kick long towards a vacant half forward. Carson comes out. Addy against him. Traps it, kick off the ground. Goes towards Mick Groz. Keeps it in. Muir into support. Hutchinson's there as well. He goes with a kick instead. Terrible off the boot. Popovsky the only one back there. He can't take the mark. Under pressure from Mays. Handball towards Lentini. Got a bit of time in the back pocket to pick it up and then drill it back towards 50. Oh, terrible kick. Gerard coming the other way. Rusty, does he make him pay? 45
he
out.
Will.
And
he will.
Comes
he
in.
He will. Oh. Behind. You've got to watch Rusty. Don't worry about the umpire.
Barry O'Toole-like. And it's one behind to Gerard. So 5-4-34 Invalide. They lead Bell Post Hill 3-5-23. And that's on the Common Affine Hotel second quarter scoreboard. 25 and a half minutes played.
We've got the board working over there, but it's not quite right. But we'll
they'll get it right once we tell them.
So Barton short over the top. Kick again. Interception picked up there. And again, it's
Girardi
looking to pick the ball back into the middle of the ground. Carson on a lead and a good pair of hands there. And he's taking the mark forward pocket. That boundary line must be the fair way there, is it?
He looked very deep, didn't he?
Throw in, says the umpire. So obviously he's taking the first grab on the inside and the second one over the back. And the umpire out the far side said it's going to be a ball in after discussions with the central umpire. So Grundle doing the ruck work. Barton is also there. Barton and Grundle. Ball comes out the back. Picked up Fantella. Couldn't get it away cleanly. Barton goes back and collects it again. Grundle's also trying to force his way through. Picked up Sulix. Able to get boot to ball. Far as Violet. He's taking an attack.
Oh,
shrugs it off. Then kicks long. Back towards the full forward position.
Bounce.
How it bounced. His numbers are there with...
Cam Addy.
And pushed him straight down as well.
I think Carso might have played for that one just
a
little bit.
Already he's taken a couple of dives in midair to try and get free kicks. And the umpires haven't been sucked into it. But they must have got the wrong umpire down there, and he got sucked into that rubbish of getting pulled to the ground. What a disgraceful, disgraceful free kick. And they've had three free kicks for three goals here.
So Carson now with an opportunity to kick his third from about 25. Kicks towards goal, and that's a much easier kick for him this time. He's got his third and the sixth now for Invalide. They're 6-4. They lead Bell Post still on 3-5, and we have gone. 27 minutes gone. Second quarter, Common Affine Hotel, second quarter scoreboard.
Well, again, though, even though there's been a couple of ordinary decisions, they are playing a lot better footy. And in all that talk about whether what down-the-ground free kicks, we did neglect to mention that the actual down-the-ground free kick was given by Tari, and that was very, very undisciplined play that cost them a goal. He just ran into him a minute and a half late, and it was very undisciplined from the big fella. I can't believe the umpire gets stooged for that. He just threw himself back.
Back in the middle.
Scoreboard right yet, or are they still getting
just it? 1 point off.
1 point off, all right.
So Hybens goes up, gets it down, rode by Fantella. Kick was smothered. Drew over the top of it, handball it straight back to Fantella. Goes inside, 50. Holzfein starts from behind. Burke's there as well. In front, Fantella folds it up again. Burke's there as well across half forward. Falls over at the crucial stage. He might get the ball back. He does. He handballs it over the top. Hawks with the numbers if they can get out of trouble. They do. Through the Mick Groz goes towards half forward. Terrible kick off the boot. Bell Post still under pressure. Popovsky over the top of it. Handballed. In fact, it's Zulix as well there. And, I smell a punts.
Yeah, he's going to do it.
I smell a punts.
He's going to do it.
Geez, I tell you what, it took him long enough to get down there too, the umpire.
It's
a free kick. Bell Post still's going to take it.
Gets down any further, he'll split his undies.
And Lima will take the free kick. Centre wing on the outer side. He's got Pisano wide. Barlow gives him a lead. He goes further than that, though, and gives it as much as he can. And they just take the mark. Violet takes the mark. At half back for the Hawks. He chips the ball over the top. Hutchinson takes the mark. Centre wing, uncontested. He goes inboard. Looking for Follett again. Takes the mark. And Fitty. Somebody ran off the mark. Will Kelly. Will Kelly ran off the mark. And Jack Follett will bring the footy down to 50.
Yeah, what, he'll nearly dob this.
Inside 50, because that's a good 50.
I tell you what, you talk to Tony Doze, and he says blokes like Willie Urquhart and Fantella are underrated. This bloke's underrated. I have underrated him. He's a better player than I thought he was.
And he should be in the team of the year.
Well, I didn't have him in.
We had him in, did we?
I reckon I made a blue with him.
Yeah,
I think I should.
He comes in, right foot kick, bringing back with the breeze.
Tell you what,
and he's
tell
kicked
you what.
The goal. Much better kick than his old man, I can tell you that. He puts it through for his first of the afternoon. And a seventh for Inverleigh, 7-4-46. And they lead Bell Post Hill 3-5-23. Common Avino tells second quarter scoreboard, 30 minutes played.
I might have to ring up Fuji and change that. I might have to try and get him in.
Oh, God.
I don't know who I'm going to put out.
You're like dialing his tips. What are you talking about? I know that, but
I just...
Too late now.
I knew I'd missed him last week when Smithy put him in. I thought, geez. Matter of fact,
can play.
He might even start next year in me top 10. There you go. That's how much this kid's improved. He didn't play a lot of footy last year.
What about Mick Groz? Did you have him in the team?
Yes.
Yeah, Mick Groz in.
Yes.
Had a good first half, Mick Groz.
So back in the middle of the ground, Grundle in there doing some ruck with this time out there by Lovett. Lovett tapped it back towards centre wing. Fantella tried to get first hand on it. Belpo still working a little bit harder now in the middle of the ground. And the ball has been in a neutral situation there, so we'll have a ball up.
How long have we gone?
We've gone 30, over 30.
I said they could build them and win the game this quarter. If they got five more minutes, they might have nearly done that.
So the ball tapped out in the middle of the ground. Meehan picks the ball up. Tried to get it away. It's stolen, taken out of his hand, kicked into the forward line. Barlow goes up with strong hands. He takes the mark. Looking for a running player. Found it in Fantella. Quickly into the forward line, but only as far as De Blasio. Read that nicely. Plays on now. Comes club room side of the ground. Out there, well, Armstrong. Mark not taken. Popovsky goes back and collects it. Looks up, kicks forward, and finds Burke. So Burke now, he's about 45 out. Got Will Kelly a little bit further afield, and we'll find Kelly. So Will Kelly. Not too sure how far it is from here. It's a little bit far to the side. What, 35, 40, you reckon?
Yep.
So he's kicking back into the bit of a breeze, but probably the left-hand post would...
The left-hand post would probably put him with the breeze, blowing that way a little bit, maybe.
So Kelly now comes in.
Oh, jeez.
I don't know which left-hand post he was looking at, but I couldn't see one out there, and that's out of bounds for the full.
How many weeks out of the team has he had?
Well, he wasn't there last week. He missed about four in that May-June period.
I don't reckon he's 100%.
No.
It's not the Will Kelly that I've seen before today. He's out of sorts.
So Hutchison now with the ball deep in defence. We've gone over 32 in this quarter.
How do they go so long, these quarters?
He kicks the ball in, comes outside 50. Over the back, Armstrong taps it down. Grundle over the top of it, picked up there by Gerrard. Got the handball away. Ball runs to the boundary line and over. So we'll have a ball in.
You can leave for halftime if you want, Grub.
Oh, I'm going to have to.
Just go and get the plate ready for us, will you?
Well, what are the quarters supposed to go?
25 plus time on.
No, 20 plus time on.
20.
So how do you get an extra 12 minutes?
Goals.
It's 20 plus time on. I can tell you that now.
So Lovett clearance from that ruck contest. Goes back inside 50. Coming across, Costello couldn't pick the ball up. Holes fine, emerges. Gets the handball away to Kelly. Kelly at goal. And this time he's missed to the far side of the ground.
Two out in the full. How many more do you want? It's strange. It used to be 25 minutes and time on and you'd go 30 minutes. Now it's 20 minutes and time on. We go 35 sometimes. I think they blow a stoppage every time there's a stoppage. Every time there's a ball up.
We don't do that here. Ball kicked in from the full-back position. Goes outside 50. Over the top mark. Oh, is it taken? It's been paid. Umpire says, yes, that's okay. And I'm not too sure it is out there. It's Armstrong, actually. It was. It was a good grab. He goes back towards centre wing. Limer brings ball to ground. Picked up in the lead. Tried to knock the ball forward. Belpo still with a late opportunity. Fantella handballs back inside to Urquhart. Urquhart looks up. Goes long into the forward line. Mark will need to be taken. Popovsky can't do that. Ground level picked up by Gerrard. Has a player out by himself. It's Groswell. Ball favours him and he picks the ball up. He goes back the other way. The kick wasn't good. It's either himself or Kelly will go back and collect it. So Kelly now not going to kick the ball. Goes with a handball over to Fantella. Left boot long back into the forward line. Out the back, Walsh takes the mark in a hole by himself. So Walsh now just to relieve a little bit of pressure. Decides to transfer play back club room side. And the ball has been marked by Gerrard as the siren sounds.
What?
Ball has been marked.
I thought you said ball.
I said, yeah, the ball.
That is.
And at half time, Inverleigh 7-4, 46. They lead Bell Post still on 3-5-23. And to this date, Paul Carson with 3, 1 each to Adam Muir, Dean Muir, Jordan Drew and Jack Filett for Bell Post. Still there, three goals. Jaden Etridge, Luke Turner and Will Urquhart.
So half time in the qualifying final. It's Inverleigh 7-4-46 they lead. Bell Post Hill 3-5-23. We'll take a break. Back with the second half after this on 94.7 The Pulse.